Welcome to the Butterfly Effect. I'm Chris Horner. Today is the men's individual time trial of the 2021 Olympics. Now we have 39 riders and all just absolute talent when it comes to the time trial. They finished the men's race on Saturday just 3 days ago, so there's not much rest period between the 235 kilometers that they did on Saturday and today's Wednesday's 44 kilometer individual time trial. They'll do two laps of 22 kilometers each. It's the same circuit that the women do, just one more lap. So we know the climb is just outside the Fuji International Circuit. It's about 5 kilometers long, but it's really only the last part of the climb that's difficult. Now, when the riders get up this morning, they gotta already start to figure out how to get warmed up properly for today's stage. It's a difficult task when you just got done finishing a hard race like the Olympic road race of 235 kilometers on Saturday. Really important how all the riders prepared throughout Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday's more or less rest days. There's not enough days to really train big. I would assume one of those days they would have done as an opener for the legs so that the legs don't get too blocked. You need a full recovery on Saturday, and then Monday, probably another recovery day. I would assume Tuesday they'd do a little bit of effort. They'd go out and see the time trial course. Maybe they open the legs just a little bit, but still not a big training day. Maybe a 10, 20 minute effort day of training, and then some nice smooth riding to get ready for today's time trial. Now this morning, after having breakfast, they'll go in, they'll see the course possibly one more time in the morning. They'll go back, have something else to snack on, and then they're gonna arrive at the Fuji International Race Course where the course starts and finishes for today's Olympic individual time trial. Now, when all the riders get there, they have their warm-up spots and they're gonna hop on the trainer and start to warm the legs up. Tom Dumoulin's there, he's with the Netherlands, so you know they always have a cooling vest on when they're warming up. We saw it with all the Dutch females when they're doing their race in the road race and of course in the time trial too. Walking through, getting caught on camera, is today's female rider, Van Vooten, who shows off her gold medal right there by Tom Dumoulin. And Dumoulin's so focused, he doesn't even look over. He's still on the trainer, he's got a vest on there, and he's warming up. He's got a big objective to go out here and try to win gold at today's men's individual time trial. Now, Tom Dumoulin's been MIA throughout a lot of the year. He started Team Jumbo-Visma, then took a little bit of a break, and now he's trying to come back to win gold, like I told you. Today's race, absolutely stacked field. 39 riders, and they're gonna split up into three waves of 13 riders each so that the riders won't overlap each other while they're out on the course. First wave of 13 will do the first lap, and when they finish their first lap, then you could start sending the second wave of riders to follow behind them, and that way nobody overlaps. The first wave of 13 is Hugo Uhl, the Canadian, who has the fastest time on the day. He'll hold in a hot seat for quite a while until Remco Evenepoel, coming from the second wave of riders, is doing a blitz in time. Remco Evenepoel's position on the bike is something beautiful. He's always tucked, his head is solidly underneath, under by the bars, so you can't even see as his hands are going straight into his helmet, just fabulously low and aerodynamic, and he'll come through and dislodge the Canadian rider by 33 seconds. And that second wave of rider, though, is the Colombian, and I'm talking about Rigoberto Urán. Rigoberto Urán had a fabulous race at Tour of Suisse in the time trial that he won, then finishing on the podium there. Since then, Rigoberto Urán at the Tour de France, where he was fighting for a podium, but he blew up on the last mountain stages, and he'll finish 10th or 11th at the Tour de France. I can't remember the spot exactly. Now, he's coming into today's time trial a little bit unknown, but he comes through with the fastest time to dislodge Remco Evenepoel in today's race by 3 seconds. Now, we all know that those were the solid two waves of riders. Those three riders were the best out of those two waves, but the third wave is the best because that's why they're leaving last. We're talking Primoz Roglic, legendary rider, fabulous form all season until he crashed at stage three of the Tour de France. Now, we don't know exactly where his form is. Rowan Dennis, he's been world time trial champion. We don't know where his form is because he didn't participate at this year's Tour de France, so we haven't seen him for a while. Filippo Ganna, he is the current individual time trial world champion, and I don't know where his form is because he didn't take part in the Tour de France either, but he's last to leave the ramp on today's race. Now, besides him, we have Stefan Kuhn. We got to see him two times during the Tour de France, each time performing well and getting a second on the first time trial in the Tour de France stage. Tom Dumoulin, another unknown rider. I mean, there's a lot of X factors when you're looking at the last wave of 13. Tom Dumoulin hasn't really raced much since he stopped and took a break early in the year and left his Jumbo-Visma team, coming back just about a month, month and a half ago and doing some of the more B races throughout Europe. Those are the favorites. They're all solid riders. We all know that they're capable of winning today's Olympic individual time trials, but there's a lot of question marks next to their name. The only rider in my mind that doesn't have a question mark starting today's race is Wout van Aert. Everything we'd seen from Wout van Aert at the Tour de France when he won the time trial stage at the Tour de France and then the next day won on the Champs shows that he should be able to be fantastic in today's individual time trial. But the question mark, if there is one, you got to remember he was the most dominant rider in the men's road race on Saturday. That was 235 kilometers long. So it's a little bit different when you compare it to the time trial that he won at the Tour de France and then racing only about 35 kilometers on the Champs, but winning in spectacular style. Now, can he put together back-to-back races like he did at the Tour de France and be that spectacular? He was my favorite going into today's time trial, so we'll have to see if he can live up to those expectations. Because you got to remember, in the road race on Saturday, from the bottom of the last climb to the finish line was about 40 kilometers, and he was on the front, basically pulling all of the favorites on Saturday's men's road race all the way to the line. He was covering every attack, pulling it back, then on the front, driving it, only to cover more attacks again, and then winning the sprint for second to take silver medal in the men's road stage. Now today, can he put it back? Can he put all that top level form again into the legs for 44 kilometers to go before he can go on vacation after the Olympics this year? Tom Dumoulin is the first of the big favorites to leave, and he's going 10th from last. When he takes off and he goes through the first time check, just under 10 kilometers, he has the best time of the day. That shows he's on blazing form. He'll go through the Fuji International Raceway, first time pass through, and he'll have the first best time there too. Only problem is Primoz Roglic is coming up behind him. Primoz Roglic at the first time check takes best time away from Tom Dumoulin, but there's some problems for Primoz Roglic too because you got Filippo Ganna, the current world individual time trial champions on flying. He's going through the first time check half a second faster than Primoz Roglic. With one lap completed, the top five favorites are only separated by 10 seconds, and it's been a drag race the first 22 kilometers, and it looks like it's going to be a drag race for the next 22 kilometers to figure out which one of the five is going to win gold at today's Olympics. Now, Wout van Aert was the only one, to my surprise, that wasn't performing on today's stage. He'll finish the stage more than a minute and 40 seconds down on the winner for sixth place. Now, let's get back up to the top five, because Tom Dumoulin is the first to leave the International Raceway, and he's putting on a how-to-turn-your-bike clinic. If you ever wanted to know how to turn your TT bike properly, go back and watch Tom Dumoulin leave this International Raceway. He sets up for every corner perfectly. The left turn that's coming up, he's all the way on the right before the apex, starts on the right, dives left, just missing the fencing as he comes in the left turn, sets up for the next right beautifully. When he leaves the International Raceway, he has the American, Brandon McNulty, in his eyesights. Brandon McNulty's up there and he's coming into the left turn. You'll see Tom Dumoulin as Brandon McNulty exits the left. He's fading right, and Tom Dumoulin just blazes up the inside and passes Brandon McNulty. McNulty gives a little look to the left, but he knows he's not going to do the speed of Tom Dumoulin because Dumoulin is out for gold in today's race. He's setting a blazing time, and throughout all of his checkpoints, he has been first and fastest time. The only problem is you got Primoz Roglic coming behind, and Roglic is on a mission for gold at today's Olympics. He's got his own traffic to deal with, and it's Casper Asgreen that Primoz Roglic has to dislodge. Not once, not twice, but three times Primoz Roglic has to pass Asgreen before he finally dislodges him. Up in front, Tom Dumoulin will cross the finish line to take the best time away from Rigoberto Urán, who held it previously before him. Now behind, I told you, Primoz Roglic has been flying. They haven't been giving us the most accurate time checks because they had him leading by about 10 seconds. But when he crosses the finish line, he puts in more than a minute into Tom Dumoulin. So Primoz Roglic, fastest time when he comes through. The only problem is Primoz Roglic went off about seventh from last, so he's got six more riders that he's got to wait for. Primoz Roglic will be sitting in the hot seat with his Jumbo-Visma teammate Tom Dumoulin in second. Behind, it's Rowan Dennis, the Australian rider who's coming up to the line. He was fast throughout all the checkpoints, but not fast enough to beat Primoz Roglic or Tom Dumoulin. He'll cross the line for third fastest time, but there's still big names behind. We're talking about Filippo Ganna, who's been setting a blaze in time. He had the fastest first checkpoint of today's race, but now he's been dropping time throughout the stage. Stefan Kuhn, who was up there with the five favorites, comes across the line and loses out on a silver medal by just seconds to Rowan Dennis's time. Filippo Ganna will cross the line and he'll drop back 1 second behind Stefan Kuhn. We're talking about Primoz Roglic putting a minute into all of the favorites on today's race, and he did most of it on the second part of today's race. The first lap finished, they were all within 10 seconds. When the second lap finished, he had a minute lead on second place, Tom Dumoulin, and just behind him, we're talking about second, third, fourth, and fifth, all separated by 5 seconds. It was a fantastic stage to watch. The drama was intense throughout all of the stage. Primoz Roglic, the Slovenian rider, he absolutely blazed the second half of the course. He is looking the thinnest I have ever seen him and just looks like he's on fabulous form. The first thing that popped into my head today when I've watched him win at the gold medal in the individual time trial was just, what did we miss from the crash that he had at the Tour de France? How much better could the Tour de France have been if Primoz Roglic was there battling with the other Slovenian, Tadej Pogacar, for the win at this year's 2021 Tour de France? The what-if scenarios in sports are what makes sports so fantastic. But today, we don't need to doubt gold medal because the gold medal, Primoz Roglic, was just blazing with his form on today's race. Tom Dumoulin, amazing comeback story after stopping the sport early in the year to grab the silver. And Rowan Dennis, who didn't race this year's Tour de France, but still came here with spectacular legs to get the bronze medal at this year's Olympics. A fabulous day for us fans to watch the podium up there with Primoz Roglic, Tom Dumoulin, and Rowan Dennis rounding out the podium at this year's individual Olympic time trial. Like and subscribe if you like the butterfly effect, and I'll see you guys real soon.